Kairos, WWE News, and Rumors here, showing you another video. This time I have an epic Raw for 13:15 review from the O2 London, England. Okay, now I'm going to give my opinions and views on what happened, the results of Monday Night Raw. John Cena kicked off Raw with a WWE United States title defense. He faced Bad News Barrett, accepted the open challenge. It was an absolutely brilliant match. I will give it 4 out of 5 stars. John Cena pulled off new moves. That springboard-like mid-air stunner was absolutely sick. And it was a good match. Bad News Barrett blew the roof off the O2. And John Cena, I think he got poor reactions, but oh, good match. The Divas battled to determine the number one contender. It was the winner of that match was Paige. So, Paige blew the house. Paige blew the roof of the house because she's from England, Norwich, England, I think. So the London people will cheer for her because it's her home country. And yeah, she just got good reactions and the battle royale was very quick. Cesaro faced Randy Orton in a short match. Then Tyson Kidd got interfered, so Kane came in. And he restarted the match as a 2-on-1 handicap match. And if Randy Orton won, he would pick a stipulation for his match against Seth Rollins for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. It was a good handicap match. And Randy Orton pulled off a perfect RKO out of nowhere and Tyson Kidd. And he springboard jumped over the rope. Excellent RKO and he won. So he gets to pick a stipulation. Dolph Ziggler was set to face Seth Rollins. But no, Seth Rollins said that he doesn't want to. So then they had a backstage talk. And then Seth Rollins and JNG Security wanted Kane to lay down for Seth Rollins so they could pin him. So Seth Rollins could pin him and then he could choose a stipulation. Yeah. Sorry about that. And Stardust faced Fandango. Stardust pulled off a quick win and Fandango got good chairs as well. Dean Ambrose did dirty deeds. Adam Rose and won. Very quick match. The Miz and Damian Sandow. It was an alright match, I think. And Damian Sandow won with a roll up. The Lucha Dragons versus the Ascension. I can't stop shaking my head. What is WWE creative team doing with the Ascension? What's wrong? They were being promoted on NXT as big tech teams. Now they just become a failure on WWE. Their first month was very strong, and after that, they've just been losing every match. What are they doing to the Ascension? I'm starting to think that they'll be released soon because it's like WWE creative and no ideas of the Ascension. And Luke Harper faced Ryback. And Ryback won, I think it was by disqualification, I think. It was a good match. And then Dean Ambrose came to fight Luke Harper throughout the whole arena. And yeah. Then Dolph Ziggler came out. He wanted an open challenge. Never accepted. Absolutely amazing match. Pulled off some sick moves. The highlight of the show was the 450 special on the outside. Absolutely amazing. Then Kane faced Seth Rollins. Kane was upset. He chokeslammed Seth Rollins. But then the disappointing man, he lay down and put Seth Rollins' arm over him 1-2-3. So Seth Rollins got the biggest stipulation. So to end the show, Seth Rollins and Randy Orton had a segment in the ring. And Seth Rollins decided that the RKO will be banned in their match as a big factor. So I'm wondering if you'll see the punt kick. And Randy Orton put the stipulation to be a steel cage match for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. So guys, this is a real review. This is my opinions and views. And I want to say thank you for watching and subscribe.